Hello children, in mathematics, geometry plays a vital role. In geometry, we come across closed figures like triangle and quadrilaterals. In quadrilaterals, we see squares, rectangles, parallelograms, rhombus and trapezium. Today, we shall perform an activity which verifies that if a triangle and a parallelogram are on the same base and between the same parallel lines, then the area of the triangle is half the area of the parallelogram. To perform this activity, the material required are crayons, colored pens, indicators, squared papers, and a ruler. Now we take a squared paper. Children, you can see here all are equal squares. For our convenience, we consider the area of each square as one unit square. Now, to draw a parallelogram, we draw two lines on this squared paper by using a ruler and a colored pen. This is line L, this is line M. Since it is a squared paper, line L is parallel to line M. L is parallel to M. Now we take two points on the line L, point A, point B, and we also take two points on line M, point C, point D. Now we join them. Children, now we got a quadrilateral ABCD. In this quadrilateral ABCD, the side AB is parallel to side CD and the length of side AB is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 units and length of the side CD is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 units. So, in this quadrilateral, one pair of opposite sides is parallel and equal. So, ABCD is a parallelogram. Now, we take another point on the line M. We take this point as E. Now, we join AE and BE with different color. Now, children, we got triangle AEB in between these two parallel lines. Now, you can see that the parallelogram ABCD and the triangle AEB having same base and between same parallel lines. Now, we shall verify their areas. To find out the area, we use the method of counting the squares. For counting the squares, we use this procedure. The area of fully shaded square is considered as one square unit. The area of more than half shaded squares is also considered as one square unit. The squares exactly half shaded is considered as half square units and the area of the squares which are less than half or neglected. We find the area of parallelogram ABCD and the triangle AEB. First, we find the area of parallelogram ABCD. We have got replicas of this figure. Now, you can see that parallelogram ABCD. Here, some are fully shaded and some are more than half shaded. Now, we denote the fully shaded squares with red dot. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 39, 40, 41 and 42. Now, we denote more than half shaded squares with blue dot. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. In this figure, we don't have exactly half filled squares. Now, we calculate the area of this parallelogram. Here in this parallelogram ABCD, the fully shaded squares are 42. And more than half shaded squares are 6. Exactly half shaded are 0. So, the area of the parallelogram ABCD is 42 plus 6 plus half of 0 implies 48 square units. Similarly, we find the area of the triangle AEB. Here we have the triangle AEB. Now also, we denote the fully shaded squares with red dot. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. More than half shaded squares with blue dot. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Exactly half shaded squares with green dot.